We've been working hard, harder than we ever have. And that's the part of where we started, trying to make the better half. The charge to who we are, and in the second that we stepping back, we'll step the fuck off and try to light up with another match. But I don't think we lose the spark, I think it kindles deeper. Smolders are the shards of light come creeping through the ether. Don't you cut me deep, I know you know that I'm a bleeder. You notice what I need and don't deceive me when I see ya. You're fucking unique, embedded deeply in my head. With presence like a peak, a piece I eat of Grateful Dead. Yeah, this a fucking cute song, I should be in Tucson. Add this shit up on the fucking playlist in the cute song, yeah. This that what we bout to do song. We know the move, the ocean's moon, that lovey-dovey groove song. That time to put your shoes on, bust a move and move on. Show me what you got and see if we've been being too gone.
When I first met you,
I was living in spite and trying to figure it out.
When you first came through,
I was living my life and getting words in my mouth.
When my face turned blue,
you were making me smile and getting me off the ground.
Mic check, one, right. Two. This is Strawstone.
I'm Modest K.
This is StrawTalk
After Dark.
Episode 10.
Welcome.
Second episode of the night.
Yes.
Shout out to Drama the Artist, our first interview.
Yeah, shout out to that interview. It was a really good interview.
Yeah, make sure you go check that out.
On our YouTube. We did pin
in the comment section our YouTube channel. We would love for you to go and subscribe to that and go check out all these interviews. Let us know people that you'd like to see. Let us know things you'd like to see. We appreciate you.
Yeah, definitely.
The intro was C10 Tucson. You can find that exclusively on his page.
Sheesh. Such a good song.
Yep. Go go find C10 after this episode and follow his page and check out that song. Show some love in the comment sections. We're going to keep that as our intro for a couple days, I think.
Yeah. We love it.
So this is kind of a special episode. If you were with us earlier, you know that we had Drama the Artist.
Mm-hmm.
That interview went really well. This episode, we have Psychotic the Mad-Man.
We do.
He is somebody that's been with us for Nice Enough Open Mics. He's mm-hmm. done some shows with us. He's one of the hungrier young artists here in the city of Omaha, Nebraska, just in case you are joining us from somewhere else.
Yes.
Take the time to shout out our YouTube viewers.
Yes,
we
shout
appreciate
out,
you.
Shout out YouTube.
If you're watching on YouTube, smash that thumbs up and smash that subscribe. And even turn on the little bell thing. That'll tell you when we upload shit. So that would
be
dope.
Always uploading. We upload every day.
So, what up, Homer? Good to see you, man. One of the homies from back in the day. Before we get on to our interview here, we got to do our Nice Enough Straw Talk self-serving bullshit.
We sure do.
Which just means that we want to tell you we got t-shirts for sale. All of the proceeds are going to go towards people that are, like, displaced from work, like, within the music industry.
Yes.
What else do we have going on? We got artists that are making a bunch of music. Check out the Nice Enough Artists when you get a chance. We know Jay Influential's been in the studio. C10's got that new song.
Brady Raps.
Dropping new music all the time. Ashton's always working. Elevator Rebellion. Smoke Break has a video coming out on April 20th.
Yes, they
so,
do.
Less than zero. Make sure you check that one out.
For sure.
Some of the stuff we haven't really talked about, make sure you're putting some time to, like, learn a skill.
Yeah, I mean, this is a really good time to, learn how to do something new that you always wanted to do, because we've got nothing but time right now.
Some of us. And shout out to the essential folks out there, too.
Yeah, shout out to everybody who's still working.
I've been working
you
every
have.
Day.
Yeah, every day.
I've been helping out the good people at Cops Pizza. I will be having some food to give away here sporadically as it comes available. I'm also going to be working My pay for working is actually going to be a pizza that I can donate to people in the community. So I look forward to seeing you guys. It'll be a wave through the window because I'm all about practicing social distancing. But yep, I look forward to dropping some pizzas off. Shout out to Cops Pizza and the great people there.
Shout out.
They've donated thousands of pizzas in the last few
Literally
weeks.
Literally thousands.
So awesome people. What up, Jeremy Lifford? Shout out. Hello, cousin Shannon.
Oh, my cousin Shannon?
Yeah. Woo-hoo. So before we bring the young man on, which we're about to do.
I think my cousin Becky's on, too.
Kayla had a little something written in here.
What? Oh, sorry. Wait. I don't know where you... Oh, okay. So anyway, we have a group that we started when this all went down as creative people doing creative things. It's a good outlet for anything creative or artsy, whether it's drawing or painting or fabric arts, if you crochet or sew or music, whatever. My aunt's a potter. She does pottery. She shares in there, too. It's for everyone. It's a good distraction, and we absolutely encourage you to go check it out. Also, I want to shout out to all of the female artists out there, all the moms, the single moms holding it down out there. Shit is hard. All of the wives and daughters and sisters. Big shout out to all my sis, all my sisses, all my sisters. But also shout out to all the men out there. Being great too, all single dads and other guys that are being great for the women in their lives. I know my babe holds me down.
We work so, at it just like everyone else.
Yeah, definitely. So we see you dudes too.
Yeah.
So shout out to you guys.
We went outside and we raked leaves tonight.
We did.
It was kind of cute as fuck.
It was so adorable. We did yard work together.
So just remember to treat the people around you that are there every day, the people that would never leave, the people that would never abandon you. Make sure they're good, too. You know what
Absolutely.
I mean? So check on there could be somebody hurting right next to you or a little scared. Don't downplay people's fear and don't play into it.
Facts.
Just good things to bring up. Hello, Brittany. What up, Tyler Johnson? He's coming up soon. He has an interview coming up. what up, Troy Hellhouse? It's my guys. Why don't we go ahead and should we play something by him before we bring him on? Why don't we play his live performance?
Okay. Yeah, let's do that.
We're going to play a little bit of Psychotic the Madman performing live. I'm pretty sure it's at a Nice Enough show.
It is.
It's got this banner. We have this banner from all of our shows hanging behind us just to like feel more like we're at home or something.
Yeah, to feel like we're on stage.
But we are going to be bringing the man on soon. So if you wanted to go and share to all the groups or share to your friends and say Psychotic the Madman's about to start his interview, we'd love and appreciate that. If you don't have time to stick with us the whole time, we understand that too. It's late. We do put this up on YouTube pretty quickly. So we appreciate everyone. Here is Psychotic the Madman live at the Lookout Lounge.
Don't listen to your opponents. What they don't teach in classes, this is knowledge I'm rapping. Opportunities are endless with passion and practice. Society changes packing like they've just been evicted. When you have a shitty day, put this song on and listen. Society changes packing like they've just been evicted. When you have a shitty day, put this song on and listen. Cause it's hard out here in this world after everything. Get up to the work every day, never being here. What does life mean? Life is feeling meaningless. Man, I know the struggle in me. You want to hearing this? If you feel the same, like some change. I can feel your pain. Okay, take another hit. Never be ashamed. A brave life to be. You can overcome anything if you believe in this.
Those
so
Nice
cool.
Enough shows were fun.
Oh my god,
they
so
are
fun.
Fun,
I miss them.
They're coming back. We're kind of on some everyone being involved, a whole community feel. And things are great right now. Omaha's on a really good tip. When things return, I believe in the people that are making music, the people that are networking. We'll be right back to that. So,
absolutely.
Sorry, that made me a little sentimental to see that.
Well, we got a little verklempt over here.
So why don't we go ahead and bring the man on?
All right, let's go.
We're going to go ahead and call Jacob, a.k.a. Psychotic the fucking Madman, one of my favorite people in the music scene.
All right, here we go.
Boop. Hey.
What's up?
Hello.
Hi, guys.
Welcome to Straw Talk.
Welcome. How you guys doing?
We're doing good, We're man. How good. The heck are you?
Doing all right, man. Living life, just trying to get by like everybody else.
You seem to be in pretty good spirits, young man. I love to see that.
Absolutely, man. You got to stay positive in a time like this. If you're negative, it's only going to get worse, right?
Absolutely. You know I'm all about that. So.
Yes, sir.
Man, first of all, I just wanted to say I've really enjoyed knowing you as an artist, man. I enjoy working with you. I look forward to working with you again. Shout out to your boys at Street Life, King Crime and Alex and all them mofos. Those are friends of the family. So I appreciate working with you guys, and I appreciate both of you guys coming on this week.
Hell yeah, we definitely appreciate working with Nice Enough Entertainment too. We love you guys.
One thing that we kind of wrote about you, and we started with the live performance for a reason. You are one of those guys that you don't just go up there and walk back and forth and just rap into your microphone. You give a fucking performance. You put your music and yourself right in front of people. Tell us a little bit about that.
So growing up, I was always a performer. I think the first artist I ever listened to was DMX, and I don't know if you guys remember the song X Gon' Give It To Ya.
Oh yeah.
I remember ever since that time, I fell in love with music, and I was always into acting growing up when I was in school and everything. So just having a good stage performance is something that I've worked on and I've perfected on since I was a kid, since I first started doing music.
You know what? Since we're always learning and always growing here, you're the second person to say DMX, and I just realized that we need to get like some sort of chart that we can like okay, we got another one for DMX, hey. And we should start like seeing who, then we can see like who really is like the truly most inspirational, because DMX is a surprising one to me, even though I fuck with him, but I really like making animal sounds, so that's my biggest thing.
Oh yeah, and definitely with DMX, you know, the reason why I liked him so much was just like, I love the thing about him is that he brings that whole attack into his music. You know, it's like he's going up to the mic and he's going to punch the mic with his vocals, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, that energy is just like unmatched. So I actually love DMX. I remember Rough Riders Anthem, man. That shit was fire.
I went ahead and marked that down. DMX too.
We got two for DMX.
She's got it. She's got it.
It was all over the shit. We can find your music on all streaming platforms, right?
Yes, sir. You can find all of my music on any platform that you use. I don't have it on Pandora or iHeartRadio yet. That's something that I'm trying to work on. But, you know, like Spotify, YouTube, Apple Music, Tidal, all those major platforms you can find Psychotic the Madman on.
Awesome. Damn. And if I can just take a little quick break to say, how's our sound? If you can hear us, if you're happy to be with us, slap those heart reactions. It lets us know that everything's crystal clear. We went from being watchable to we want to be great. So go ahead and hit us with that feedback and let us know if you're here rocking with us with Psychotic the Madman. But I think what we should do next, one of my favorite songs that he performs, and I'd even say it's like a little local hit. And I don't give that credit out to too many people and too many songs, but I would put it on like my top 10 like local like songs of the last year. Okay. Let's play Up, Up, and Away by Psychotic the Madman.
All right, let's do it.
What up, Jenna?
And I go up, 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 and away. Spark up the doobie, stuff with some tank. And I go up, 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 and away. Take a trip up to Mars, getting baked all day. And I go up, 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 and away. I'm from a different world, I am not from this place. And I go up, 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 and away. And I go up, 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 and away. And I go up, 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 and away. Spark up the doobie, stuff with some tank. And I go up, 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 and away. Take a trip up to Mars, getting baked all day. And I go up, 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 and away. I'm from a different world, I am not from this place. And I go up, 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 and away. And I go up, 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 and away.
So that's just a little sample
of that. So
of his song
out.
Up, Up, and Away that you can find everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
So we have a few questions for you, man. We're going to start it off a little simple, but so with everything happened with the virus and all that, and first of all, shout out to Corrupted Promotions. I seen Jenna in here. And any other promoters or any other people streaming or that are trying to create and do dope shit, I salute you. Yes. Nice Enough as an ally.
Yes, thanks for stopping by.
Yeah, thanks for stopping by. That means a lot. But so with everything that happened with the coronavirus and all this bullshit, what did you have that like was canceled or had to get rescheduled? And what are some like things that like maybe it gave you time for?
I will say... putting aside the music and everything, you know, a lot of people who have known me know that I work for a company, you know, I work for Hanson's, I do windows, siding, and roofing and gutters. I was laid off from that job, you know, I worked for that job for a long time, and I poured a lot of time before the coronavirus into that job. And a lot of people, you know, I took a lot of time to, you know, I perfected, you know, I wanted to be the best at the job that I could possibly be, you know, I wanted to be great at it. But the one thing that coronavirus has helped me realize was just the fact that, you know, music has been something that has stuck with me the whole time. You know, it didn't just give up on me when coronavirus came around. They didn't let me go. Music never let me go. It's always been here for me. And music has been something since I was a kid that I knew that I had to do because I had the talent for it. But since the coronavirus, I have really been able to focus on my music career, which is really cool. I've done a lot of stuff. I've recorded a lot of songs. I have so much unreleased music that I'm just excited to share that. I'm ready for this to be over with. I'm ready to go out there and share it to the world.
That's a great answer, man. And that kind of answered her first question as well. So I'm going to let Kayla like ask her first question, which is actually her second. But that's a great answer, man. We just kind of got to be on our feet. And like you said, the art never dies. Now, that's why, like, during all of this, we still got to move respectfully, professionally. We got to network properly. And we're going to see each other on the other side of this, and we can all keep growing together and probably all have some new skills to go with it.
Yes. So that kind of ties into my question then. So how do you think that the current events will affect how you move in the future in regards to the music industry? Is there anything that you're doing now that maybe you didn't do before and that you will continue to do even after like concerts resume and stuff like that?
I definitely feel as if the one thing that coronavirus is going to help me with in the future from everything that's happened is just, like I said, the one thing it's made me realize is music is something that I want to do. It's not just a hobby to me. It's something that I love, and I want to make it a career. I want to be able to go out to people, you know, and just do music regardless, not just doing it because just for a hobby. With the coronavirus, the one thing that I'm going to take away from this and be able to use in the future is just knowing that, you know, like I said, music is the one thing that has stuck around. When I don't have anything else to do, when I'm not working or when I'm not doing anything else or I'm not with my child, music is there. It's there to help me, and it's there to help me escape from reality. So I know it's also helped me extremely, helped me get back into my writing to where I used to be before, you know, everything to when I was younger. I used to write so much, but now I'm back to where I was, and I'm like, I'm thankful. You know, there's a lot of negative and there's some positives behind this virus. And I think we as a people, we have to realize it's just not negative. There are some positive things to do, and it's terrible what is going on right now, but use this to your advantage and be the best person that you can be.
Absolutely, man. For you to be the age that you are and to have that type of maturity, man, I love seeing it. I've seen you grow so much in this last year, man. So before, I know we want to do a debut of your song, and I think that should be coming up here pretty shortly. So to lead into us debuting your new song, which we're pretty excited, and we do thank you for letting us be a part of that, man. That's really cool of you. The song's called Miss Jane, and it's a remix of The Plug Walk, right?
Yes, sir.
So the way we're going to lead into this is going to be interesting. Let's say you got your Bluetooth speaker ready, and you're outside a concert in the tour bus, and DMX is outside smoking a blunt. And you can just tell this dude's relaxed. You can tell he's in a good mood. Maybe you've seen him kind of looking inviting. You got like a minute to tell him what you're about before you play your new song. What would you say?
That is a really hard question, but I love that you asked that. Basically, what I would say to DMX in 1 minute would basically, I would tell him along the lines of just, you know, I'm an artist. I'm definitely an artist. You know, I come out here, I put my soul into everything that I do and all the songs I've written. I want to, you have 1 second to where I can show you a song, and you don't have to tell me if I'm good or not. Just tell me what I need to improve on. You know, I don't want you to be like, oh, you're so great. I want you to tell me from someone who is a professional, for someone who does this for a living, what do I have to do to get to your level? And I want you to listen to my song. I want you to critique it enough to where I know I can go back home and make it as great as you think it can be. You feel me?
I love that answer, man. So the fact you have that small amount of time and you want to get across that humility and that you don't just want his acceptance, you want to work, you want to grow, and you're showing what you are. You know, it's like, I think that like a lot of people get it fucked up to where it's, they think they have such a short amount of time to show why they're the best. And a lot of people are turned off by that. So we're going to go right into your song.
All right, here we go. Miss Jane.
Miss Jane by Psychotic the Madman.
This is a treat, by the way, because this is unreleased music off the album. And because I love Justin and I love his movement, I love Nice Enough Entertainment. This has not been heard by a lot of people, so this is a treat for everybody who's tuning in right now.
All
right,
here it goes. Much love. Throw those heart reacts out if you fuck with the song.
First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Always toking on a blunt, all the time I'm rolling fatties. Yes, I kill the sadness by burning through a baggie. First I'm feeling sadly, start chiefing, then I'm happy. Blowing through an ounce, I rolled another doobie gladly. Smoking so much gas, you would swear that I was gas. All these haters picking on me like I was some acting. Trying to kill my vibe, so that's why I'm smoking mad trees. Living through the struggle, it's like every day's a bad dream. I will never break, even if your haters crack me. All you clowns is jokes like the back of Laffy Taffy's. A master of my art, every rap I write is crafty. Switch it, watch me kill it, got these bars, I'm spitting mad. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. I ain't smoking, I'm purple, I got the nerdy flow like Urkel. If I'm choking all this weed, it got me moving like a turtle. I'm different from the rest, cause I'm verbal with my lyrics. This sticky icky so loud the entire globe can hear it. A pothead, I'm a stoner man, just look at my appearance. Rhymes illegal, dark and evil. I look into the mirror, see Johnny staring back, but then psychotic starts appearing. These voices I keep hearing, telling me the end is nearing. Goddamn, this is a dream, I snap awake and keep on staring. I'm weaving out of traffic, switching lanes, and now I'm veering. And you ain't on my level, bitch, cause you ain't got the clearance. When I got this kush up in my brain, my mind just feels the clearest. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away.
Alright, that was super fire.
What'd you guys think about it?
Yeah, I like that a lot.
What do you guys think? Slap those heart reacts if you fuck with the Plug Walk remix, Miss Jane by Psychotic the fucking Madman.
Yes.
I see your manager just popped in. What up, Alex? Somebody said, why are you going so hard, bro?
Why are you going so hard?
Why are you going so hard, bro?
That's Holden. What's up, Holden?
Man, you hurt. I think you're hurting feelings out here, man. You gotta be careful going that hard. People get insecure when you start rapping. You know what I mean? He's rapping.
I think it's my turn for a question.
Kayla says she has a question.
I do have a question. Okay, so if your music was heard 50 years from now, what do you think people would be saying about it? And is there a particular message or a motto that you would like to be known for?
You know, definitely. Absolutely. There is definitely a motto that I live by, and that's something that I go by every single day. And As a kid, you know, I definitely, it took me a while just to get used to it. But that motto is, don't try so hard to fit in when you were born to stand out. I think a lot of people, when they hear my music and they hear what I talk about and everything, I try, every single song that I write, I think about it is I try to put as much talent, as much fire to it, because I want it to stand out from everybody else. I want people to listen to my music 50 years from now and be like, you know what? That kid had, he doesn't even look like those words can come out of his mouth. Or he doesn't even look like he would do anything like that. But the cool thing about him is that he, regardless, he still went up there and killed that and sure. did it, you know? And I want people I'm a heavy metaphor rapper. A lot of people have compared me to, like, you know, a white Lil Wayne, to where I put a lot of punchlines, I put a lot of bars into my music. And for me, growing up, like, listening to DMX, Eminem, Yellow Wolf, I always listened to their punchlines, and I was like, you know what? That's the type of rapper that I want to be, and I want to be able to, you know, I want to stand out. Somebody hears a punchline, they're like, he just lined this up with this and then circled it back around to the same thing he was just talking about. Like, that's something that I want people to realize. I think as an artist, I think if you don't have creativity or your music is bland, you don't throw those punchlines in there or those jabs in there to get people's attention, you're not, you know, people, it's not going to stick into somebody's mind. So every single time I make a song or I do a performance, I want it to last in someone's mind to where they can remember me, you know?
Great answer.
Yeah, dude, I love that, man. And I think you definitely do a good job of kind of, like, every time you perform, whether it's at an open mic with 15 people or whether, you know, we got a couple hundred there, I feel like you're really a good, like you're selling yourself, you're being true to yourself. You definitely do it right, and I'm proud to see how you move.
Definitely.
Absolutely, man. I'm proud to be here, man. I love you guys, and I think the one thing that I really like about the interviews, your guys' interviews a lot, is that I think for a lot of artists, it helps them, you know, it helps them realize that, you know what, I'm not the only one out here doing this, and it helps them, you know, network. That's a cool thing with this, is that it gives a chance to people to network with people that necessarily they've never met before. Could it, you know, if they haven't seen you at a show or something, this gives you an opportunity. There's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of promotional teams out there, but the one thing that I do like about this is that, you know, you guys are doing something regardless of what is going on right now. It's a constant way of networking, and that means a lot to us artists out here.
Thank you, man. We've had our insecurities and our doubts as we've like obsessed over this and put hours into it every day. But as I see this YouTube fill up with all these artists that we respect and love, I want to see 100 of them, man. I want to have this as a library of something we can all go back to. And what you said about networking is absolutely right. I say it almost every episode. Talk to each other in the comment section. Go follow each other. If you're here, we have the same goals.
Right, absolutely. And like we are here to be a bridge for you all to do some cool shit. So keep doing it.
Let me say a couple shout outs here. What up, Matthew LaRoe, Kat Thompson, Dylan Killowee, Johnny Bliss, great interview last night. You were fucking great. Was it last night, Johnny?
Yeah.
It was a great interview.
It was.
Yeah, man. We got a lot of people in Lincoln that we fuck with. But so I think I have one more little thing to talk about before we play another song. So we heard that you might have an announcement coming up with McDread out of Omaha.
All right.
A little bit of a name change. Tell us what's going on.
Absolutely. So I'm very excited to announce this, and I've been saving some stuff for this interview that I'm going to post later. Michael McDread and I have linked up, and he is actually going to be creating my new logo. For Psychotic the Mad-Man. And as a lot of people know, you know, being an artist, it's not just about, I'm going to say this before I get into the news, and this is just one thing I want to say to everybody who's watching. You can be the greatest artist in the world. You can be the greatest artist. You can be talented. You can have the best bars. You can have the best beats. You can have the best recording, the best setup and everything. But I'm telling you right now, if you don't know anybody, you're not going to get anywhere. It's not about what you know. It's about who you know. And I feel like as an artist, you have to be marketable so you catch people's attention. So with that being said, after this mixtape, so what I'm doing here is I'm dropping a mixtape in June, and I have a Up and Away is going to be officially released this month. And then I have another song, another single dropping next month, which is in May, which is called On My Grind. And then in June, my first official mixtape will be here, which is 13 tracks. And then after I record that mixtape as Psychotic the Madman, it will be a complete renovation, and it's going to be psychotic. It's just going to be psychotic. But we're going to drop, like I said, we're going to drop the Madman, and we're going to leave it as psychotic, but we're going to get rid of the P, and we're going to spell it this way. It's going to be S-Y-C-H-O-T-I-K. So it's just going to be psychotic. It's going to be a little bit more marketable. I feel like Psychotic the Madman is just too big of a name. But Psychotic is a little bit more marketable. The merch line is incredible. Michael McDread is such a talented person. I cannot wait to get it ready and to get it going. It's in the process of being done. But like I said, after I do Psychotic the Madman, the mixtape, Psychotic, that's what I'm going to stick with, and that's what it's going to be. And one more thing, and this is the last thing I'm going to say, the K. The K on the end of Psychotic. The reason why I put the K there is because I have a huge and heavy influence to my brother, my fam, King Crime. I have learned so much from this guy. He has an interview, I think, on Thursday with you guys.
Yep.
Sure.
But I put the K on the end of Psychotic because I've been heavily influenced by him to keep doing what I'm doing. And the dude always reminds me is just to believe in myself, because I know I have the talent to be something great. I've done a lot of stuff in music. I've been in the game for a really long time. I used to do pep rallies in my high school. I used to rap for pep rallies. You know, I've gone to Miami and performed. I've been to Kansas City and performed. But the one thing I've learned a lot from King Crime, so I respect him, and I wanted to put that K at the end of Psychotic just to give him credit.
That's awesome, man. And we're all about showing people love while they're here. It's okay to be fans. It's okay to respect. It's okay to follow people that we love and we respect, and people that we think are doing it the right way. Don't bring flowers to my funeral type of thing. You know what I mean? So much respect for you to give that little bow to him. Shout out to Mike Fantastic. You know, that's like, I'd consider that my OG. I know he's kind of been going through a little rough patch, but shout out to him. Shout out to King Crime, man. That's a good dude right there. Me and him, every time we need to talk about anything, it couldn't be any more direct, and I fucking love it. So,
and he'll be on the show this week.
We hear a little noise in the background quite a bit.
I think it's from...
Okay. If it's just ours, that's fine.
No, it's not ours, it's his.
Okay. So what we're going to do now, since you're dropping the Madman part, we did a little research today.
We sure did.
And we didn't know that you're dropping the Madman too, but we have a little bit of farewell to your other brethren and your other madmen that you are no longer going to be associated with. So
right.
If we can just have a moment of silence while we say goodbye to the other madmen that...
These are the other absolute psychos out there.
So you'll always be one of them. It's Jack Nicholson for you.
Yes, sir. I'm actually going to get a Jack Nicholson tattoo right here with the Shining. You know, breaking through the door.
So there's your farewell tour to the other madmen.
Yes, to the other madmen, for sure.
And I think now what we're going to do is we're going to play On My Grind.
All right.
Absolutely, man.
All right, so everybody, we are playing On My Grind. Before we go, we'll probably play your Miss Jane one more time. We have a couple more things to talk to you about, and then we're going to be heading out. So thank you, everybody that's with us. Thank you for still being here. Slap them heart reacts anytime that you feel the itch to do that.
Yeah.
Are we having... Straw talk technical nope. difficulties.
My grind, always on my grind. I see shining like a star, cause I'm always on my grind. Everything I see is hot like a stove top. I'm whipping up some dope like I had a crock pot. I'm posted on a block with the pack in my backpack, strapped in my pants. Don't make me blast that. Fuck, I gotta hustle. Trying to make this fast cash, run up in a bank with that Glock and a black mask. Creeping through the night, looking like I'm fucking Batman. All these rappers garbage, music like a trash can. I'm a bad man with some bands in my hands. Staring at her pussy like I gave my girl a cash can. Sucking on my dick, she about to give a lap dance. I don't need a job, bitch, cause I got the trap plan.
Hey, that's
my I'm back.
We are all back. Let's talk a little bit about the merch that you have available.
Yes.
We have a little graphic here that we can show everyone.
Yes, we sure do.
Absolutely. So you guys, as you guys know, like I said, I'll be dropping the Madman, but right now I have a limited quantity of Psychotic the Madman, so it might be, you know, some gold a little bit down the road. So if you guys are interested, I do have the t-shirt right here, Psychotic the Madman. They're going cheap right now. I'm gonna sell it to you for $10. And then if you want a hoodie right now, if you guys want it this week, I'll sell it to you for about $25. You guys can come out and get a hoodie. Like I said, it's just gonna be a new image, and then there's also gonna be a new merch line to it also.
Absolutely. I'm gonna need one of them throwbacks for sure. I'll be hitting you up this week.
Definitely.
Yes, sir.
And let's go ahead and play his debut again one more time, just because I feel cool that he did his debut with us. So if you missed it earlier, here's his debut of Miss Jane.
Yes.
Oh.
Skirter. Skirter. Yes, sir.
Meow.
First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Always toking on a blunt, all the time I'm rolling fatties. Yes, I kill the sadness by burning through a baggie. First I'm feeling sadly, start chiefing, then I'm happy. Blowing through an ounce, I rolled another doobie gladly. Smoking so much gas, you would swear that I was gas. All these haters picking on me like I was some acting. Trying to kill my vibe, so that's why I'm smoking mad trees. Living through the struggle, it's like every day's a bad dream. I will never break, even if your haters crack me. All you guys is jokes like the back of Laffy Taffy's. A master of my art, every rap I write is crafty. Switch it, watch me kill it, got these bars, I'm spitting mad. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. I ain't smoking, I'm purple, I got the nerdy flow like Urkel. If I'm toking all this weed, it got me moving like a turtle. I'm different from the rest, cause I'm verbal with my lyrics. This sticky icky so loud, the entire globe can hear it. A pothead, I'm a stoner, man, just look at my appearance. Rhymes illegal, dark and evil. I look into the mirror, see Johnny staring back, but then Psychotic starts appearing. These voices I keep hearing, telling me the end is nearing. Goddamn, this is a dream, I snap awake and keep on steering. I'm weaving out of traffic, switching lanes, and now I'm veering. And you ain't on my level, bitch, cause you ain't got the clearance. When I got this kush up in my brain, my mind just feels the clearest. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt. Get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change. No need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away.
Hey.
Yeah.
I fuck with that.
I fuck with the heavy.
Again, the only place you can find that song on this episode, so you guys better go run it up. It's played twice on this episode. I'm gonna need y'all to go subscribe to that YouTube. That way, I got a feeling that this is gonna be one of the most watched episodes.
You think so? I'm calling it now.
I'm calling it.
All right.
He's a pretty charming young man.
Yes, sir. You're pretty charming yourself, too, Justin.
Oh, isn't he, though?
Knock it
and
off.
And he's so handsome, too.
Shout out to Jeff Rahman there. Shout out to, again, to Street Life and Alex. We're gonna let you plug some music, give some shout outs, then I think we're going to end this double header.
Yes, sir. So I would just like to say, first of all, shout out to the people right here on the video camera with me. Shout out to my dog, Justin Strawstone. This dude probably has the heart of a lion, man. He is every artist that he works with, man. I have the utmost respect for this dude. Shout out to his lovely wife right there. Shout out Kayla, Modest K, Big Heart. You got some bars. I can't wait for a next show. I want to give a big shout out to Street Life Promotions. Alex, my dog, my motherfucking dog, dude. I like to give a big shout out to Crime, King Crime, J Rome, G Money, everybody on that label. I appreciate the time time so much, and I just love, and I'd like to give out a big shout out to my beautiful boy Parker, man. I hope that one day he can watch this and just say, look, that's my dad right there, and that dude is super psychotic.
Hey, we do have one more quick question. Shout out to Gunner B, first of all. That dude tries to tune into every single episode. He has an episode coming up. That's how he like handles shows and shit too. This kid works and he grinds nonstop. One of my favorite people. So he said, when did you record your first track?
I recorded my first track literally when I was probably a freshman in high school, or at least eighth grade. I recorded my first song, and I will tell you this right now, and this is, I'm just going to say this. I remember when I first started rapping, I was terrible. I was absolutely awful. I had people that used to make fun of me and laugh at me all the time, but here's the key to with anything in life, with anything that you do in life, practice makes perfect. I wanted it so bad. I loved music. I loved hip hop. I loved the feeling. I loved it. You know, and I wanted to be it so bad that I would just lock myself in my room and I would sit there and I didn't even have instrumentals. I used to listen to old mixtapes, old rappers, and just listen to the beats that they rapped on and write songs to it. Like it just goes to show that if you work for something, or that if you believe in it that much, and if you want it that bad, you're going to make it happen, because now people respect me and people are like, oh my God, you're so good. You're going to make it, you know? And that's just one thing I want to tell people, is that practice makes perfect.
Yeah. Don't get satisfied. Always try to push your pen to a different level and whatnot. We do want to just shout out everyone that joined us tonight. Tell you to hit the YouTube subscribe. Shout out to Psychotic the Madman. Shout out to Modest K for running two episodes tonight.
Shout out to Strawstone.
Much love. What we're going to do, we don't always do this, but we're going to play your song one more fucking time, and then we're going to slowly end the episode. So much love. We will talk to you soon. I can't wait to see you perform live soon. Keep treating people decent, young man.
All right, here we go.
I love you guys.
Much love, brother.
Everybody out there,
thanks.
Thank you so much.
That's all we got for tonight.
Thanks for tuning in.
We're going to let this song play out, but we are done for the night.
First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt, get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change, no need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Always toking on a blunt, all the time I'm running fatties. Yes, I kill the sadness by burning through a baggie. First I'm feeling sadly, start chiefing, then I'm happy. Blowing through an ounce, I brought another dude. We gladly smoking so much gas, you would swear that I was gassing. All these haters picking on me like I was some acting, trying to kill my vibe, so that's why I'm smoking mad trees. Living through the struggle, it's like every day's a bad dream. I will never break, even if your haters crack me. All you clowns is jokes like the back of Laffy Taffy's. A master of my art, every rap I write is crafty. Switch it, watch me kill it, got these bars, I'm spitting mad. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt, get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change, no need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. I ain't smoking, I'm purple, I got the nerdy flow like Urkel. If I'm toking all this weed, it got me moving like a turtle. I'm different from the rest, cause I'm verbal with my lyrics. This sticky icky so loud, the entire globe can hear it. A pothead, I'm a stoner, man, just look at my appearance. Rhymes illegal, dark and evil, I look into the mirror. See Johnny staring back, but then psychotic starts appearing. These voices I keep hearing, telling me the end is nearing. Goddamn, this is a dream, I snap awake and keep on steering. I'm weaving out of traffic, switching lanes, and now I'm veering. And you ain't on my level, bitch, cause you ain't got the clearance. When I got this cush up in my brain, my mind just feels the clearest. First I wake up in the morning, roll myself a blunt, get up on a bus and go to work to make a buck. I'm like, every day's the same, I got a pocket full of change, no need to complain, cause I got my Mary Jane. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away. Yeah, 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 cause I got some Mary Jane. Fuck this world and fuck my primes, I'ma smoke this pain away.